All right, so today I'm going to be talking about the aspects of online billing. Now, the entire process of online billing was supposed to be to make our life simpler and easier and quicker, and it's all like debit deducted immediately from checking accounts and we don't have to worry any longer. Instead, it has become the opposite in a way. You know, we have the paper mail, the old version of the paper mail, there it is, you gather it, you put it on your desk for a while, and then you write the checks, you put the stamp, and then you send it out. That used to be the old way. That did take a little time. However, as an organization feature, it was pretty easy and pretty quick, because normally your bills would be in one location. You know, you have them on the desk, you know, in a pile. And then you could just pull them out one at a time, read it, write the check, and out it goes. But with online billing, it requires not that at all. You have to have the password access, you have to have your username access, you have to have, remember when the billing cycle is, because once you've gone electronic, your billing cycles are different. Every company has a different billing cycle. And so we're ending up with way too many billing cycles out there. So it's become a full-time job for many people, full-time, just trying to maintain their e-billing, or just trying to maintain, even if you try to switch and say, okay, put it with my bank or whatever, that looks really swell for like three or four companies. But then after that, there are the ones that are just, forget it, we're never going to be with your bank. You can't have like an easy SIEM system. It's not going to happen. So we're still in the very beginning stages of online billing, the very beginning stages. Now, because we're in the very beginning stages, that means it is another occupation. So we've created another occupation. So, as I stated before to a person a friend of mine, was there was a 10% factor. You know, you have to charge 10% for the service, 10% of any of the bills, amount of the bills going out, and that is your wage. That would be a normal wage for a billing person. However, I think it's become so excessive that we have to control it. We have to control it, even with that 10% wage. We have got to go into forcing the companies. Now here I am like trying to like state control again, but yeah, in this case we have to. We have to start. I mean, I'm pretty sure everybody will like this, even the IRS. So we'll go to, you have the beginning of the month cycle, so you have your bill on the 1st. So you can be a company and you can make the choice that you resume all of your billing to the 1st or 2 weeks after that to the 14th. So we have the 1st or the 14th as an allow. Now, so then the billing person, the online e-cycler person, the person that's actually doing all this billing, is not hassled into complete pandemonium. By you stating your bill is on the 26th, and this one over here is saying it's on the 13th, and this one is saying it's on the 2nd, and this one is saying it is on the 27th, and you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I mean, it's absolute pandemonium out there. So we're talking about forcing the companies themselves to be the 1st or the 14th for all of their customers. I don't care who you are. I don't, if you're an insurance company, I don't care who you are. So we need to mandate this as a rule out there, like a general regulation for all companies in the United States of America. And I would imagine in other countries in the world also. It's a very, very good advice. Because you've created a work effort already of the 10% to the billing person. At this point, the billing people are rebelling, and they want double. So we're gonna have to clarify and bring it back. So the companies themselves, who are just like today we charge you today's price, and then just writing it in. No, it has to be prorated. You have to take that little time. If it's a new service, a new person, and let's say 5 days out into the new service, you have to prorate that particular monthly cycle. So normally I say it was $30. Well, then there's an extra $5 for those extra 5 days or whatever. So they have to do that in their own mathematical equations. All right? But that would be charged only on the 1st, and that would be your billing cycle, or be only on the 14th. You understand? So this is an update we have to do for all online billing, or online billing is a fail and we're running back to paper. You know what I'm saying?